there is a verse in Srimad Bhagavatam. The verse is Gunadhikhan mudam lipset anukrosham gunadhamat maitrim samanat anvichena na tapar abhibhuyate. So this is a verse which Narad Muni, he speaks to Dhruva. For the next semester you'll learn this. So it's a very important instructions for all of us. When we see a person who is more learned than ourselves, what should we do? We should offer our, we should welcome him joyfully in our life. If we see somebody who is inferior to us, he wants help, what should we do? We should help him to bring up to that platform. Where at least which you are in, you should help him raise to that platform. And if you see somebody equal, then you should try to become friends with him. So this was the character of Gaur Krishna Maharaj. When he used to meet somebody very superior to him, like he used to always praise Vrindavanchandra Das Goswami, that he is very more intelligent and very learned than him. So he used to always welcome and appreciate him. And he used to appreciate, always used to appreciate others. And with Gaur Krishna Maharaj, there was never a time when he used to meet people who are even 20 years younger to him, he used to easily make friends with them. And used to encourage them. I was one of them. And certainly with the equals, he was very friendly. But this, if you meet somebody who is lesser than you in capacity of understanding scriptures or is very weak, then he used to make friendship with them and help them to come to the platform of proper standard devotional service. So this was one of the qualities which I like very much, and I got inspired from that, and I tried my best to follow in that footstep, although it is not easy in different circumstances. But he did that wonderfully. He used to make younger generation very comfortable with him. One of the other qualities of Maharaj was that he has studied Srimad Bhagavatam very deeply. If you go to, there is a place in Barsana where he used to have his ashram, and there he used to study, and there is a timetable on his cupboard there, still exists, it's still there. He used to study for 15 hours. For so many years, he used to have a timetable, the whole day timetable. When he is not doing katha, then what was his business? He used to study. 14 to 16 hours. There's still a timetable exists there. If I can go and make a screenshot of that, and I can send it to all of you. Right from after Mangal Arati and chanting completes, then that whole business throughout the day was only studying Bhagavatam. No other business. I got so inspired by that. We got so much opportunity, my good fortune, I would say, that I was spending good amount of time with him because of I was working on my Gurudev's books on Srimad Bhagavatam. I was a person from English background, not good with that English, but still Indian English. And I was good at Marathi language. But I was given a service to compile books in Hindi language. So I was not so comfortable with the language and everything. But one thing I did was I started spending time with Maharaj. I spent around 12 years. From 2008 up to 2008, I started spending regularly. So few things which I noticed from his life was, he was a hard worker in terms of preaching. He's very enthusiastic in preaching. Other than his studying Srimad Bhagavatam for a long, long, he has, he was also very much eager to preach. In a month, he used to have at least 3 kathas going on. 7 days kathas. At one place, then he used to go to a different place, and a different place. So 21 days used to be, 21 to 25 days, he was always engaged in speaking about the Lord. And one of the specialities of him was that if he is supposed to give a katha on, let's say, Bhishma Stuti, but he is not preparing for that. He is never preparing for that. I personally was observing him. He was supposed to give a katha, 7 days katha is going on Bhishma Stuti, and he is preparing for some other subject matter. And then he goes down and speaks so eloquently, so beautifully, with the depth, with the writings of the acharyas from on Bhishma Stuti. But during the whole day, he's preparing on something else. So that was how Bhagavatam was. He was captured by Bhagavatam, or he captured Bhagavatam. And in Mayapur, for 40 days, in two parts, for 40 continuous days, not continuous, but two different parts, once 30 days together and then another 12 days. Each day, 6 hours per day, he spoke on the entire Srimad Bhagavatam. And then, same in on Chaitanya Charitamrita and Chaitanya Bhagavatam, for 30 continuous days, he spoke for 6 hours every day on the entire Chaitanya Charitamrita. That was his capacity of presenting Srimad Bhagavatam. Hare Krishna. Till today, I meet many senior devotees in ISKCON who say that they get inspiration from Gaur Krishna Maharaj. One of them is Bhakti Vigyan Goswami Maharaj. I met Bhakti Vigyan Goswami at the airport, Calcutta airport, and Maharaj asked about Gaur Krishna Maharaj. I asked about Gaur Krishna Maharaj, have you heard his lectures? And Bhakti Vigyan Goswami said, yes, I heard so many lectures. He is super fast. He has heard some, and Loknath Maharaj and so many senior of Maharaj's disciples, Prabhupada's disciples also, they hear Gaur Krishna Maharaj's lectures. Till today, they hear. Now, regarding his departure, how he left the world. Yes, it is true what Sri Krishna Prabhu is saying. I was the eyewitness, because Maharaj was staying in our home in that Kartik when he was in Vrindavan. His base was Jhasi, but he used to stay in, whenever he comes to Vrindavan, in our house, we have on the top floor, we have a very special room for the guests. So many sadhus used to stay there, even Jagadatma Prabhu stayed for some time. So Gaur Krishna Maharaj has spent some time there. And that night, that is today, 4 years back, it was around early morning at around 3:15. Maharaj happened to come down from top to my room, and he knocked at the door. And I opened the door, and Maharaj was sitting on the steps. And he said that, Brajasundara, I have some pain in my heart. I said, Maharaj, please come in. And he said, probably this can be due to the gas or something like that. He was saying like that. So he came inside, I made him sit, and then he started doing some yoga in that state. And I prepared myself, and then we went to Braj Healthcare. And Braj Healthcare, the doctor immediately understood that this is a case of a heart attack. And he admitted him. And the doctor gave him some tablet, but Gaur Krishna Maharaj, all of a sudden, he told me, Brajasundara, I need some water. There was one more devotee also, Atinder Das, he was also there with us. So he asked for a glass of water. So we had no glass, so I borrowed it from another patient, so I cleaned it up, gave him the glass of water. He woke up very peacefully. I was very surprised that he was in a pain, but he got up very coolly and calmly. He drank that glass of water. He went back, took a deep breath, and that's it. He left the body. He left the world. So this, I was a witness to this. Because it happened in front of me. And after that it was very difficult for me to relate that he has passed away. But the hospital there, it said that you should take him away. You should go to Mathura or somewhere, some other places. Go to take him to Mathura. So we called for the ambulance and we started for Mathura. And when we reached there, that the other hospital declared him that he has left his body. So it was very difficult for me because all of them started crying. Everybody, all the people around there, 15-20 people gathered and everybody was crying. And it was very difficult for me to keep faith that how can he go? He was just there with me. And how can he go? So I understood that no hospital is going to take him. So I called up Gaurang Prabhu. Probably Radhanath Maharaj Yatra was in town 4 years back as well. I called up Gaurang Prabhu and requested him that I told him that I am giving you 15 minutes, Prabhu. In 15 minutes, I want all your doctors of Bhaktivedanta Hospice to be there in the hospital. Just 15 minutes. Do anything in the world you want. I am bringing Maharaj with me. I give you 15 minutes. Please see that in 15 minutes. If there is any hope because after a heart attack, there is some chances are there. Within 2 hours, if you can pump him, bring him back, something has to be done, if it can be done. So, Gaurang Prabhu said, okay, done. So, before we could reach there in 15-20 minutes, the doctors were there and they checked with Maharaj and checked the pulse and everything, and finally they also said, okay, Maharaj has left the world, Maharaj has left. So that was the time I was actually convinced, okay, that he has left. Gaur Krishna Maharaj was very thorough with his scriptural reading. He has read Srila Prabhupada's purports many, many times. Once he was in Pune, he was giving a class in Pune. And adjacent to his class, there was a screen, projector screen. And whatever Maharaj was speaking, he was speaking from Prabhupada's purports. Everything he was speaking from Prabhupada's purports. So Radhesham Prabhu was very surprised how much depth of understanding he has on studying Srila Prabhupada's purports. So he was very scholarly, very learned, and Prabhupada's purports was his life and soul. He was speaking from that. Gaur Krishna Maharaj and we share a very close relationship. And can you come here, Suraj? I want to show you how I used to come here for 2 minutes. I'll show you I used to have a habit of catching Maharaj's hand in a certain way. Come this way. Sit down. So whenever I used to meet him, this is how I used to catch hold of his hand, put my hand here. And I used to walk like this, keeping his hand to my heart sometimes. And this was the way I used to walk. So the day the night before he left the world, for 20-25 minutes I was holding that hand and I was carrying it like this. And next day when he left the body and then they were about to do the funeral ceremony for Maharaj. Nobody knew, I didn't tell this to many. People know this. But Maharaj has that same left hand which I used to hold. It was out from that. The body was kept on a wooden thing and the Maharaj's hand was outside. And somehow nobody realized that. I was doing parikrama and I saw that same hand is outside. I took his hand, put it in my head, kissed it, put it back again. And then the funeral started. But this was, I really don't know what was this. But Maharaj's that hand was as if it was a last goodbye. So with this inspiration, we many devotees, they often question me that on whose inspiration have you started the school? Yes, Gaur Krishna Maharaj desired that there should be such school in Vrindavan. Prabhupada desired it, we know. Prabhupada desired it. And my spiritual master, Radha Govind Maharaj, used to have a school in Bihar. He used to have a school like this in Bihar. He used to write a verse on Bhagavatam on the blackboard. He used to write, do the anvay. He used to do the anvay. There used to be Prabhupada's purports and there used to be Acharya's tikas around. And he used to explain each and every verse like this. Like this, he taught four cantos to so many of his disciples. Disciples, not just disciples, others also. Whoever was there, he taught them. Gaur Krishna Maharaj had made notes for these four cantos. It's there. We have a desire to print it. He told me, you should print that. Certainly, in future, we'll print those things. How detailed. And I'm very thankful to Venugopal Prabhu that he's doing the same thing. Like my Gurudev used to teach. And Gaur Krishna Maharaj has explained me how Maharaj used to teach and he's doing the same thing. So I'm very thankful to him. I'm indebted to him. So he desired to have a school. He desired that all the devotees should have taste for Srimad Bhagavatam. All of us should have it. Srimad Bhagavatam should be our life and soul. And he left and then that one sentence he once said to me, there should be a school of Srimad Bhagavatam in Vrindavan. He said once. And then I went and took permission from my Guru Maharaj. So then finally I got association. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very mysteriously, Sankarshana Prabhu got involved. And then we started putting efforts and it started. So I am here, I'm begging to all of you. I put my head unto the feet of, unto the lotus feet of all the devotees who are here and studying. That I wish to sincerely thank you for studying Srimad Bhagavatam. Sincerely thank you. I am not able to study. I desire to study like this, but I am not able to study, but I am willing to sacrifice this. But you study. You study. Srila Prabhupada took a lot of effort in writing Srimad Bhagavatam and propagating it. It should not go in vain. All of us has to seriously study Bhagavatam and continue this movement of Srila Prabhupada and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ahead. In whatever circumstances it comes, we have to continue. We have to give our best. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.